Hi everyone and welcome to this video. First of all, many thanks to Simon, who is one of the YouTubers that I follow, and therefore I asked him to send me a picture of himself and his little brother to make a painting of him. So this is the picture that he sent me, and I will show you the process of this painting. As I initially intended to film the entire painting process but did not find a way to figure out how to put up my camera, I decided to show you the footage that I have and made some work in process pictures of the painting and will give you a small tutorial on varnishing in the end of the video. For this painting I used a canvas cardboard sized 50 by 70 centimeters. A cardboard is just a paperboard which is wrapped with a canvas and can be painted like a regular canvas. I painted the background brown just to have a base layer already. In the beginning I started to block in the background. I painted it blue in the first place, and afterwards, to not make it look boring, I made the background design. Therefore, I added masking fluid over the painting, so the portraits themselves, just to cover them up, and used quite amount of liquin, white, translucent grayish tone and some blue to make these strokes in the background. And important thing here, when the background is done, remove the masking fluid right away and do not wait until the painting itself is dry. Because if you wait, you risk pulling some of the background paint off when you remove the masking fluid. As it was a sunny day, I put everything out in the sun to dry completely, and as I used liquin for the background, this took only about a couple of hours until it was dry to the touch. Unfortunately, I forgot to press the record button when I did the real background, but it was a quite simple one, so I think you can figure out on your own how I did this. Before I start painting, I usually mix my colors that I use, and therefore I print out a photograph that I'm going to draw or paint from, or in this case I've sent this to my pad and painted from there. You should keep in mind, as these are all digital data, on each device the colors look a bit differently. So on my computer it was a different color than it was on my pad, and if I would have printed it, the colors would have changed again. So there is no 100% correct color to choose, and you will not be able or might not be able to mix the 100% correct color anyways, which is not important in the end, because you only have to see that the colors on the painting that you're doing fit together and look well together. So try to get a color that is quite close to a skin color, which is the most dominant color here in this painting. And if you are unsure if the color is enough skin-like, just compare to your own skin. So this is always a great reference to see if the color is too red or too green or too yellow or whatsoever. If you need some tips about skin tone or color mixing, just let me know. I will be happy to make a video about this. Just leave me in the comments. When my colors are mixed, I usually start with the most basic layer to block in the lights and the darks, which look quite spooky for a while. So I'm not this kind of a painter who puts all the color in the correct value in the first place on the canvas. So I prefer painting in layers and correcting details step by step. I think this is for me a much easier way to approach a realistic look. It also gives you the advantage to have a greater depth, because the light shines through the different layers and gives you the impression of more depth within the painting. And you will also have the advantage that you can, as the layers are thin, that you will have a smooth look in the end, so you don't have any blobs of color or something on your portraits which might look bumpy in the end. So this is overall a smooth look which you will see at the very end. The disadvantage of this way of painting, it looks quite spooky and awful quite for a long time. So if you need the pleasure of seeing a fine art result right away when you start painting, you might get frustrated with this way. Just try out what you like most. In the end, it is completely up to you which way you prefer the most. Another advantage, as the layers are very thin, these dry quite quickly, so you can go over it within half a day or the next day. If you use liquin to it, it goes even quicker. For this painting I was only able to film the beginning stages for Simon's face. I found this was a quite weird angle to work with and filming. I was not yet able to figure out how to do this in the best for me. Therefore, I added just some in-between pictures, as I told you in the beginning. And what I also did in my steps in between, I was tracing the outlines on the canvas. So I kept my drawing that was traced to the canvas. I put it over my painting. And just checked if the proportions are still the same, if my values are on the right position, and changed it every now and then. So when the mouth was a bit off or the eyes were a bit too small or too big, I was able to just trace over it. You see the line again and you can correct it afterwards. This is a great way to give you the most accurate painting in the end, especially if you're going to draw or paint a particular person. What I normally do when I have finished a painting, I do varnish it. Why to varnish it? Because of several different reasons. One of the most important reasons, a varnish protects the painting. And another important thing, what you can also see in this video, especially in my painting technique, you don't have an even gloss to the painting once it's dried. When you use areas with more liquid, for example, to make the paint thinner, it will have a higher gloss than the layers that you put the color on more directly from the tube without much more thinning it. So this will have a more matte effect in the end. You will see that the colors are not even. I tried to show this in the film here as well. So I filmed from right above and then I moved the camera a bit to an angle and you can see that not all the areas look quite the same. When you apply the varnish, all colors come back together and all get the same even shiny look. I use the Gemva from Gemblin because you can apply this varnish once the painting is dried or dried to the touch. Most of the other varnishes that I know of, you need to wait something about 3 to 12 months before you can apply it. Therefore, I think this is a way more practical use to have something covered right away, especially when you're going to sell them. This is the quickest way and the painting is protected. To apply the varnish, I just poured some of the liquid on my painting and you can immediately see that the color changes and gets more saturation, and then you just spread the liquid around to cover all of your painting. I wanted to try something new and using this sponge roller thingy, which turned out to not work at all, and then I switched over to my regular brush to brush over it. The varnish itself dried quite quickly, it was about 1 hour to have it dry to the touch, but I waited 2 more days until I really touched it just to be sure that everything was quite and sealed and fixed, not to have any fingerprints or whatever on your layer of varnish. Also make sure to have it somewhere safe so that no dust or fluff can fall onto it. So basically that's it for this video and quick tutorial about how to varnish something. I hope it was, as usual, of any use for you. If you have any questions, please leave me in the comments below. If you like this video, I would be happy if you give me a thumbs up or a subscribe or both. And to see you next time for the next video. Have a great day. Bye bye.